Dear learners, I am Dr. Shrihari Hasabnis. Today, we will discuss about another bacterial disease of the pomegranate, and the name of the disease is bacterial leaf blight of pomegranate. Every grower of the pomegranate in our area, especially in our Maharashtra, is worried about this bacterial disease. Commonly, it is known as the oily spot disease. Why oily spot? The spot looks like oily appearance, means shining appearance, and that's why it is called as oily spot disease. Now, this disease is a major threat to the pomegranate cultivation. Many farmers I have seen with the attack from this bacterial leaf blight or the oily spot, they have uprooted their orchards. So they have lot of fear about the disease, but need not to worry about the disease. You will learn how to manage the disease in our this lesson. The disease is caused by bacteria. Symptoms of the disease can easily be observed in field. What are those symptoms? Small, black, irregular, but shiny spots appear on the leaves. Under severe cases, leaves are defoliated prematurely. Certainly, it affects yield very much. Here, one thing you have to remember, the black irregular spots also we can notice in a fungal diseases. Here also I told the black irregular shiny spots, means one difference is there. These bacterial leaf blight spots are shiny. The black spot is encircled with the yellow halo. It is the typical characteristic of the bacterial leaf blight disease. Shiny black discolored spots are also appear on stem and twigs. Especially these spots on the branches appear at the joints. Under severe cases, the twigs or the branches, they girdled by necrotized or cracked spots. Necrotized means death of the tissues. And those spots are also, or those tissues are cracked, we can find. And what happens? The above part of these cracks get dried off. The reason? Due to discontinuation of the food supply to upper part. Such oily spots are not leaving our fruits. Any stage of the fruit is also get infected by these oily spots, means bacterial leaf blight spots. Diseased fruits not only show us the black spots, shiny spots, the fruits crack longitudinally, means lengthwise they crack. Under severe conditions, we can find cracking of 100% fruits in orchard. Here, along crack side, oily scar we can invariably observe. Means fruits are cracking because of many different reasons. But when it is cracked because of the oily spot or the bacterial blight, along the crack, invariably we must observe a shiny black spots. Now, we'll see about how the disease spread in the field. Primary source of infection is infected planting material. Here I am stressing the word primary, means beginning. The beginning of the disease takes place with the planting material. And secondary spread of the disease, means once disease has come with one or two plants to our field, from that plant it spreads to the neighboring plant, to the neighboring plot, to the neighboring village, to the neighboring district through a bacterial cells from the infected leaves, from the infected twigs and infected fruits. Now we'll see about what are the favorable conditions for the disease development to reach to a severity peak. One most important thing is continuous or intermittent rains for a prolonged period. Means rain should not be of heavy intensity, because during that time humidity builds up. Another thing, rain splashes, they help in spread of the bacterial cells. This situation, if it is coupled with continual temperature conditions as maximum temperature means day temperature in the range of 29 degrees Celsius to 36 degrees Celsius and minimum temperature 19 degrees Celsius to 26 degrees Celsius are more and more conducive. Now we'll turn towards the management practices against this bacterial leaf blight disease. Only with one approach, the disease cannot be managed. There are many approaches which are very easy and even nature friendly. What are those? The beginning is, how I told, primary source of inoculum is planting material. So here we have to select planting material from a disease free nurseries. So choose the planting material from not only a disease free nursery, you select from the disease free areas is the most important. Then strict sanitation of the orchard is prime important. It is most essential sanitation of the orchard. Yes, orchard with grown weeds, with poor air movement, with thick canopy, this built up a high relative humidity in the orchard. This situation leads to remain our canopy of the crop wet for the longer time. Such conditions are more and more conducive for multiplication of the bacterial cells as well as spread of the bacteria. Another point is, avoid mrga bahar under disease prone areas, means in area where the disease is regularly occurring, in those areas we should avoid mrga bahar. Why? In a mrga bahar, rainy situation reappear and this leads to more and more disease. Here also rain splashes in a mrga bahar helps in spread of the bacterium in the orchard, in addition to a prevailing high relative humidity. Another approach is, pruning implements are to be disinfected properly. As this is the bacterial disease, the cells of the bacterium adhere or sticks to the surfaces of such tools as a secateur and others. So these tools will spread the disease from diseased plants to healthy plants. And it is advised that we have to dip these implements or tools in between or frequently in the solution of good disinfectant like Dettol. Make the dilute solution of the Dettol and dip these tools or the implements in the Dettol solution for few minutes and again reuse it. Do clean cultivation in the orchard. All the fallen diseased parts on the ground, means fruits, branches, twigs, they harbor the inoculum. Bacteria can survive in the soil or on the soil with these fallen disease parts. And how long? Around the year they will be in our orchard if we will not clean the orchard. And sometime they will be dormant if the conditions are not congenial for the bacterium. Another approach is dusting of 4% copper dust on a soil. This copper dust cares to inactivate the fallen inoculum or the lying inoculum in the orchard. Another approach is plant at a recommended spacing as 4.5 meter between two rows and at 3 meter between two plants. Means we have to plant at a spacing of 4.5 meter by 3 meter. This helps in free movement of air current in the orchard. North to south spacing should be 4.5 meters, means this should be wide. This way planting adds in deep penetration of solar radiation up to tree trunk. Most important thing is, we should nourish our plants very well. So plant nutrition should be well supplemented with potash and phosphorus. Higher dose of the nitrogen increases susceptibility of the plant to making foliage more and more succulent. What happens? When we'll apply more nitrogen, the leaves will be more and more succulent and they will invite this pathogen. So we should give a nitrogen, but it should be in a balanced form. We should add much more potash as well as phosphorus. Potash helps in triggering or strengthening the defense against the bacterial pathogen. Then another approach is on pruning, undertake spray of 1% boron mixture. So when we take one part of the copper sulfate, one part of the lime, 100 liters of the water, we can make a 1% boron mixture. Under favorable climatic conditions that I told at the beginning, to avoid built up of the disease, take alternate sprays of bactericides, and those are boron mixture from 0.4 to 0.6%. Here, instead of 1 kg copper sulfate and 1 kg lime, we have to take 400 gram to 600 gram of the copper sulfate and lime in 100 liters of water. It makes 0.4 to 0.6% of the boron mixture. While preparing the boron mixture, we should take care that we need 3 containers, and those 3 containers should be non-metallic. We can use either of wooden or a plastic containers. Then another important thing in a boron mixture preparation is the adjustment of pH. The pH of the solution should be near to neutral. Another thing, spray the bacterinashak at the rate of 500 ppm is 0.5 gram and Captan 3 gram per liter. Further spray is of streptomycin at the rate of 250 ppm means 1 gram of streptomycin in 4 liters of water, and is to be added with copper hydrochloride at the rate of 3 gram per liter means 12 gram per 4 liters of water. Then another thing, avoid planting in heavy and ill-drained soils, means in such heavy and ill-drained soils, this bacterial leaf blight is more and more severe and is difficult to manage. Now, rest the orchard at least for 3 months after the harvest of the fruits. This is most important thing. Why? Because we have harvested much more energy from the plant at the time of harvest of the fruits. And for regaining that energy, we should give or we should allow at least 3 months rest to the orchard after the every harvest. So the crop diseases managed well with integrated disease management practices. Herein, not only the chemical is option. We do have options of cultural practices that I told, planting at a proper spacing, managing the irrigation system. These are the cultural options. Biological ways are there, which are Pacillomyces, Trichoderma, Pseudomonas and others. Those are the biological control agents we can use or we can integrate in the management. In addition to that, final option is the chemical approaches, means cultural, biological and chemical approaches are to be integrated into integrated disease management, and such integrated practices can keep the disease at a very low level. It means we should not be dependent only on one type of control measure. Every crop grower, pomegranate grower, as well as the learner should mind one thing. The chemical fungicides, what I had suggested over here, we should mind about their label claim norms published by Government of India from time to time. Thank you very much.